Hi everyone, how's it going? My name is Hayley Chatterton and this is Harrison, my 5-month-old son, who's just burping on camera. How nice. Mum life, eh? So today's workout is going to be based on those women who are in the first and second trimester. If you are in the third, you are welcome to join, but there will be, you know, you might need to sit out of some of the exercises. This is also designed for women who have just being cleared from their 6-week check, so I've made sure that these are very safe exercises. It's quite a gentle approach to start strengthening your muscles again and improving your endurance. So should we have some fun? Shall we? So I'm gonna place Harrison down on his play mat and hope he doesn't roll over or anything while I show you some exercises. Let's do it, mamas. Let's just pop you down here, little man. Ooh, right, so. To get started, I'm just gonna have my laptop in front of me to give me reminders of what we're doing today. But let's just quickly just warm up the body. So we're just gonna quickly just take our legs apart and just try and stretch down. Get a nice stretch in those hamstrings. You might find that you're a little bit tight. That's absolutely fine. Just nice reach down. See if you can reach over to your left ankle. So the thing about when we've had babies or we're carrying a baby is we have the hormone relaxing going through our body, so that does affect our joints quite considerably. So we have to warm up and be very careful with the movements that we do. So just nice big arm circles. So we just have to make sure that we have decent rest periods and not pushing ourselves too hard. And just the other direction. Now remember with these exercises, to your own pace, because it's recorded, you can pause at any time you like to take a rest, or if you need to rewind and go back over an exercise, you can. Okay, so we're just gonna do like a downward facing dog. So just feet nice and wide apart, just past like your shoulder width apart, and we're just going to crawl down and just stretch out. Now I am a little bit more stiff than most people. But you get the gist of a downward facing dog. And then you can alternate between the two, so bringing one leg in and out to try and just stretch out those calves and hamstrings. Okay. Like I say, I'm not a yoga instructor, but this is just a nice stretch. Okay, so just gonna slowly bring it back up. No head rushes. Okay, so. We'll go through the first exercise. I'm going to be doing this all without equipment, obviously, but it's on your terms, okay? So if you've got things like booty bands, resistant bands, you're welcome to use those. So the first one we're going to start with is going to be a crab walk. So you squat down and you step across, okay? We're going to do two across. Keeping it nice and low, okay? We're really gonna work on the strength of those legs. So, you ready to follow me? In 3, 2, 1, squat down. 1, 2, that's it. Back again, 1, 2, that's one round. 1, 2, keep it nice and low. Come on, let's really work on strengthening those legs. So that's 2 rounds. Come on, girls. We can do this. And I do invite you to please play lots of music with this. Whatever makes you feel good. For me, I've got a little bit of Lady Marmalade on in the background right now on my Spotify playlist. If you ever want to obviously get one of my Spotify playlists, just give me a message, it's fine. Okay, that's 6. We've got 2 more rounds of this. Lovely, keep it low. Now obviously with this, you can use a booty band between your legs if you want to add the resistance, if you're feeling a bit stronger. Okay, fantastic, and up we come. Okay, so make sure while you're doing all these exercises, plenty of water, stay nice and hydrated now, ladies. As Harrison agrees with me. Okay then. A lot of you will understand what it's like having a baby. Talk through your exercises. Okay then, let's go in 3, 2, 1. Squat down. 1, two. That's it. We got this. I'm just going with the music here. And so is Harry. Fantastic. Keep going, ladies. Keep it nice and low. That's it. We're halfway. If you are going to use a resistant band, obviously keep it above your knees. Okay? Come on. Fantastic. We've only got three more. So it is very important that we do keep our strength, obviously, during pregnancy, if we don't have any complications, that is, okay? This whole workout is based on people so far who haven't had any complications. Okay, fantastic, and come back up. Now, like I say, if I'm ever going too fast for you, pause the video and then play it when you're ready. At the end of the day, especially during pregnancy, just after, you will need some slightly longer rest breaks for a little while. But once you, you know, later down the line with having, after having your baby, your endurance and your stamina will improve dramatically. Right, let's go down again, crab walks. Fantastic. So that's one. Come on, keep it low. Wonderful. That's three. That's four, we're halfway. Keep it low. Woo! Harry loves this playmat, I tell you. It was the best thing I ever bought. So that's six. Come on, last one. Okay, fantastic, come up. So the next thing we're gonna do is a sumo squat. This is where you take a nice wide step, toes facing out, and we squat down, but our bums go towards the wall. Right, let me show you from the side. So we're squatting down, as if you're sitting into a chair, okay? And what we're gonna do, is we're gonna squat down, and then we're gonna pulse, okay? 10 pulses, 10 second hold, all right. So in three, two, one, squat down, and pulse. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 second hold, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Bring it back up. Fantastic. So we're really working on here in our little inner part of our thighs as well as our glutes there. Fantastic. Are we ready to go again? In three, two, one, squat down. I do apologize. One, two, three. He's a very loud boy. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Second hold. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Bring it up. Okay. One more round of this, okay, ladies? Let's have a quick swig of water. And my music stopped working. Why is that? Okay, then. In three, two, one, squat down. And we're going to pulse. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 second hold. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, bring it back up. Fantastic. So you know that now you can do a sumo squat, whether before or during or after pregnancy. Now we have lateral lunges. Again, You can add resistance to this by holding dumbbells. So when you do a lateral lunge, you come out, point the toe out, and we lunge, okay? So it's like concentrating on that leading ankle, okay? Or should I say heel? Okay, so we're really working again on those thighs. Okay, so the reason I've done it this way is if we've got like a large bump in front of us. Very excitable child now. So we're gonna do 10 on each side. If you're doing it with dumbbells, holding them, okay, but maintaining a strong back while you do this, okay? It's very, very important. So in 3, 2, 1, take a big stride out, toe pointing out, and let's go. 1, 2, there is no weight on this one. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, switch sides. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic. Quick little break. Just checking that my son hasn't rolled over. No, you all good? Excellent. Right, let's go again. Big, nice stride out. That's it. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And switch sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic, well done. So the reason I do a lateral lunge is because I found when I was pregnant and I had a big bump in front of me, if I was made to do lunges, I physically couldn't do it. But lateral lunges, you're obviously opening up a bit more and you've got a bit more space. Okay, so the next one is glute rainbows. Straighten my son. Hey you, Mr. Noisy, it's probably all the ladies can hear. Right, so a glute rainbow. So we're gonna come down onto the ground. Now, one thing with this is that firstly, I want you to just relax, okay? Let your belly flop forward. Then I want you to suck your belly button in, okay? So you get a nice, straight, strong back. Then we're gonna point our toe out and we're gonna like draw a rainbow, okay? Take your time with this exercise. All right, we're going to do 3 sets of 10 on each. This is really gonna work on your glute strength, okay? So, get into position, relax that back, let that belly flop. Okay, now suck in that belly button, strengthen that back, point that toe out, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, so I'm just gonna switch sides just so you can see me from the other side. So strengthening that back again, belly button tucked in, point that toe, if I can get in the camera. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, drawing nice rainbows. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic. Okay, so quick rest. If your glutes hurt at any point, take your knees out nice and wide, come down, and a nice sort of stretch, okay? Nice and open, so if you are pregnant, you know, you let your belly just go in between there. Okay, fantastic. I want my music to work. There we go. All right, we'll have a bit of Christina, shall we? Okay, so another set of rainbows in 3, 2, 1. Point that toe out, nice strong back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic, switch sides. Right, draw that belly button in, keep it nice and strong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic, well done. Ooh. Need to remember, well, exercise some wides, just sit and like stretch out those glutes, okay? Right, one more set of this. Okay, get into position. Strong back, remember belly button drawn in. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And now, oh, I was about to go to 11 then. Goodness me. Switch sides. Suck in the belly button, strong back. Let's go, one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. Excellent. So, last one we're just going to do on our back, or on our front, sorry, with our glutes. It's going to be donkey kick, fire hydrant, okay? So again, remember, nice strong back, drawing that belly button in, okay? So, in, so it's kick up, down, to the side, all right? So in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Nice and high. 1, 2, 3. Again, you can use a booty band with this. Absolutely fine. 5, 6, 7, 8. Woo, 9. How are them glutes feeling, ladies? Okay, switch sides. Okay then, in 3, 2, 1, belly button drawn in. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 5. That's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent work. Okay, so like I say, you can always use a booty band with that just to add a bit of extra resistance. Shh. I'm gonna get my husband to take him away in a moment. I'm trying to do a class here, boy. Suppose you keep it real, don't you? Show mums, actually. No child's quiet. Right, even at 5 months, let's go. 3, 2, 1, strong back, belly button drawn in. Even if you're pregnant, ladies, just think about bringing that belly button in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent work. Switch sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's 6, 7, 8, woo, 9, and that's 10. So you'll notice if you're using a booty band, you can't get quite as high, but if you do it without, as high as you can go, without obviously curving your spine and things like that. All right then, one more round. 3, 2, 1, strong back, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, oh, you're rolling over, 7, 8, that's 9, 10, fantastic, last one on this last leg, come on, let's go, 1, woo, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's 8, woo, that's 9, alrighty, we've hit 10, fantastic work ladies, well done. So, the next thing that we're going to go on to, working a little bit on our chest. Now this is going to be varying on whether how big your bump is, or you know, how far after pregnancy do you have separation of the abdominals. This is where you go from what works for you, okay? So if you have got separation of the abdominals, or you've got a very large bump, nice sort of box sort of created. Feet, hands slightly like a diamond look to them. And we're going to push down and back up. Now, if that's too easy, you can do something where you put a resistant band around you to give you that extra resistance. Now, if you go onto my Instagram, Mrs. Chatterton, Mrs. underscore Chatterton, I actually do show you how to do a push-up with a big bump with the band, okay? So, for those with a large bump or I've got abdominal separation at the moment, then I would say pushing from here, okay? So you should feel some resistance. Plus you've got the weight of your child giving you that added resistance. Now, if you're a bit more advanced, so sort of my level at the moment where I'm now 5 months postpartum, I'm now going from my knees but slightly tucked in and push up, okay? Notice that my, I can talk today, that I am bringing it in so I'm then working on my core at the same time, okay? Working on them tummy muscles. But this is because my abdominals have now come back together and I'm okay for this. If you are more advanced, then you can go from your toes like a regular push-up, okay? So I'm gonna do it from my level. If you're going from, like I just showed you, the absolute beginner level, or if you've got a bump or abdominal separation, go from the box shape, okay? So we do 3 sets of 10, all right? 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now obviously if you've got a bump, I'm not expecting you to come right down low. You don't want to squish baby. But to the point where you feel enough tension in your chest muscles, okay? It's still very important that we do still keep the strength in our chest as well. All right then, we're gonna go again. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. One, two, three, four, five, ooh, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Fantastic. Got one more round of this, ladies. And then what have we got after that? Bent over rows. Cool. Okay then. Are we ready to go again? Alrighty. In three, two, one, let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Fantastic. Right, well done. So, the next thing we're going to be working on is going to be, oh, if I can get up, a bit stiff here. So, we're going to be working on our shoulders next. So, just going to grab my dumbbells. So, what I say is, light pair of dumbbells, okay, ladies? Just purely because I don't want to be raising heart levels. I don't want you to be overheating. I want you to do this at a nice, gentle pace, okay? So, the first one we're going to be doing, shoulder press. So, core engaged, yes, even pregnant, you've still got core muscles. Nice, tall and straight. Tall and straight. Gosh, get this girl a dictionary. Shoulders rolled back, so a nice and strong chest pushed up. I'm going to come up, and we are going to do 10 of these, okay? All right. In three, two, one, bring it up. One, two, three. Now, this is where I said to ladies who do not have dumbbells that they can use either resistant bands or they can use water bottles, wine bottles, you know, cans, whatever it is that you can add some resistance to you, okay? Eight, nine, 10. Fantastic work. Well done. Now, obviously, then I'm happy to do another video for you guys soon, working on like how to work on your back strength during pregnancy. Shh, shh, shh. Excuse me, that is not pleasant noises. No. Right, are we ready to go again, ladies? In three, two, one, let's go. Nice and strong now. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, woo, 10. Fantastic, well done. So we still need to be able to work on things like our back strength, core strength, and things like that before and after birth. Very important. I actually found it was a really big help for me during like my birthing experience, but I know everyone's birthing experience is very different. But I just found working on my resistance training two or three times a week massively beneficial for both me and Harrison, as he's shouting right now. Right, in three, two, one, nice and straight. Come on, nice strong core. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Excellent work. So there's obviously like a lot of exercises you can do, things around your household. You know, I understand that during lockdown, everyone's bought all of the dumbbells that you can think of, whether it's on Facebook Marketplace, whether that's going to be on Decathlon, Sports Direct. People have gone crazy for them. So that's why I say you can use things around the house. You could use something like purchasing a suspension trainer. They're really good. Goodness me. You can then buy resistant bands. So resistant bands I do recommend. I got this from Decathlon and it's the same resistance as 5 kilos. So you can do a lot of upper body work with this, okay? So definitely look into it. Alrighty, one more set of shoulder press. 3, 2, 1, bring it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic. Right, so the next thing we're gonna do while you have a sip of water, we're gonna do alternating front rows, okay? Now the deal with this, you need to keep your torso like nice and strong. No swinging, okay? That's taking the momentum away from it and you are not working on your shoulders and back. Okay, so it's nice, strong, and controlled, okay? Again, you can do this with wine bottles, water bottles, resistant bands, cans as well, but I would say if you're gonna use cans, you need to do higher repetitions because they're very light. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's count to 12 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Fantastic. Alrighty. Doing great work here, ladies. Okay then, are we ready to do this again? Come on, make boy noises, not high-pitched ones. I'm really sorry, I hope no one's got a headache. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I'm off on my own world there. We've got one more set of this. And then let's do some upright rows. And I'll just show you a little bit of what you can do for your core, okay? And then obviously, if you're interested and you want me to do another one, doing different exercises again, doing a bit more on your back, for example, more than happy to do that. All right, then in 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Fantastic. So, what we do for an upright row is where you lead with the elbows and come back down, okay? Obviously, be careful if you are pregnant with your bump, all right? We don't want anyone hitting their tummies. So the deal with this is bring it up, all right? Lead with the elbows. Don't worry, you're not gonna hit your face. You're not coming up high enough for it. So we're gonna do 3 sets of 10 of those. Again, keeping your core engaged, shoulders pushed back, nice and strong back, okay? In 3, 2, 1, bring it up. 1, same pace as me as well, people. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic. Now a quick swig of water. You're a noisy boy. You're looking at the camera. Alrighty, let's go again. Second set. 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You got to love the facts with babies. They like to make a lot of noise, don't they? Bless them. Am I not giving you enough attention, Bubs? No? Because I turn around and look at me, she's going, yeah? He's definitely taking after his mum. I'm not sure if that's a good thing. Right, in 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I will show you a back exercise for this video then. So basically, you're gonna do like alternating back rows. So it's where you just hinge at the hips, slight bend on your knees, and we're just gonna do back rows, okay? Now the idea of this is you don't want to go ridiculously heavy and you don't want to be bending too far forward, and you don't wanna be standing up straight as well. The idea of this is basically to develop on your back and core strength again. Especially pregnant women, I don't expect you to be leaning so far forward because then that's a pendule row, okay? So, just a slight hinge on the hips and rowing, okay? Imagine between your shoulder blades, you're squeezing a grape, all right? So, we're going to do 3 sets of 10 of those. So, slight bend in the knees, hinge forward, let's go. 1, nice control for this. 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if you're doing this with like very lightweight, like I'm talking like cans, you really want to be doing very high repetitions on this, okay? Preferably, I want you to find something a bit heavier for this. Okay, that's 9, 10. You know, I still want you to be working on the back muscles, okay? So still when you're working the back of here. So have a look around what there is around the house. I wouldn't condone to lifting up your children to do it, okay? Okay then. In 3, 2, 1, hinge at the hips again. But like I say, you can use resistant bands for this as well. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, if your lower back is hurting from this, lower the resistance, okay? I want this to feel like a difficulty level of about a 7 out of 10, if that makes sense to you. Okay, then. One more set. In 3, 2, 1, hinge forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent work, ladies. Right, so this next set of exercises is gonna be working on your abdominals. Now, this is where some people may be able to do this, some people may not, okay? This is dependent on your body, you know, how far along you are in pregnancy. Again, do you have abdominal separation? You need to go to what your physician tells you with this, okay? But I'm going to show you just some basic exercises that I did in the first 2 trimesters. So, obviously, with pregnancy especially, we can't lie flat on our backs. So, resting on our elbows, okay? Gonna bring our legs to tabletop, and you're just gonna tap down, okay? Now, some people can do a flutter, okay? If you're after pregnancy and your abdominals are starting to strengthen, you can do a flutter, okay? But for the purpose of like mainly pregnant women or women who've just cleared and still got abdominal separation, I'm gonna do from this level, okay? So we're gonna do 10 on each leg. Are you ready? So let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I found that when I got to the third trimester, this became a bit too difficult for me. Okay, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Fantastic. Sit up for a moment if you need the blood to rush back to where it should be. I think my son's starting to get a little bit stroppy, so we'll have to end this soon. Are you wanting your mummy's attention and a nap, aren't you? It's nap time, isn't it? Yeah. He's learning to laugh at the moment and it's quite hilarious, bless him. Right, legs to tabletop. And remember, if you're those that are a bit more advanced, flutter kicks, absolutely fine, okay? 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Fantastic work, ladies. So this is why I say you have to understand your own body and know what your limits are, okay? Last set, I promise, Harrison. Yeah. Okay, legs to tabletop, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Fantastic work, ladies. So if you want me to do another video, I can do more concentrating on a little bit more on the core strength, and I can do a bit more on the upper body. Whatever it is that you would like me to concentrate on, I will do it. So, from myself and Harrison, thank you so much for joining in on this workout routine. Hope you enjoyed it. Please remember, before and after doing exercises, some nice static stretches is very important. Okay, nice cool down at the end is vital. So same stretches as what we did at the beginning of the video, highly recommend. Also have a look at things like pre and postnatal Pilates movements, some really good stretches there, stroppy boy, and some yoga as well. Anyway, take care ladies and have a fantastic day.